Hello everyone, I am Sandeep Kaushik from Genesis Mentors Pune. And today in the initiative Meet the Achievers, we have a very different profile achiever who has proved that it is not important to have a work experience. What is important is when did you started off, how you planned your entire journey, and what are your long term and short term objectives and what you do to achieve them. So we welcome Pranav Gupta. Yes. Welcome Pranav.
Thank you, sir.
Pranav, let us first tell our viewers what exams you have written in this year and what are the calls that you've got.
Okay, so this year I gave my CAT, ZAT and the IIFT, only three exams. And the calls that I got were IIM Calcutta, Kozhikode, IIFT and all the new IIMs along with MDI, SPGN and IIT Bombay.
Great, Pranav. And what was Pranav your CAT percentile?
My CAT percentile was 99.71.
99.71? Can you throw light on the breakup as well?
Okay, so in DIL it is 99.92. In quant it is 98.53.
Great.
And in verbal it is 95 point something.
So it was almost 95 plus in all the sections with DILR going to a very different level. Hmm. Pranav, as far as I remember, you are one of our very very serious students who started off his or her preparation way back. So can you just discuss your profile with the students that first of all, how much total work experience you have till now, and when did you started off your preparation for CAT? When was the first seed of MBA sown in your heart?
Okay, so as of today, my work experience is 10 months.
Oh great, only 10?
Yeah.
Great.
So the first time that I got introduced to CAT was actually by my dad, who is a professor.
Okay.
So I used to always think that I am good in maths. So he first he brought a paper of CAT and he was like, can you solve this? And in the first time of my life, I was stumped that I can't solve the DILR question.
And that was in your first year of graduation,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, the first year of my graduation.
Great.
So after that, I started studying like how could I solve that question, the maths part. And I was always a good reader. So this helped me to, you can say, do the verbal section.
So great. So did you actually started your preparation in your first year just after this incident, or it was some planning second, third year, final year?
Okay, so the first year that part was done, like how to solve that paper.
Yes.
And how I can do that. But the actual preparation started from around second year, third year. My third year birthday gift was the study material for CAT.
Great, great.
So, but the thing was, you can do it yourself to reach around 30% or 40% of prep. You need a polishing.
Great.
So that was time when I came about in Pune, because Pune was the nearest city to my home.
Wait, from where did you did your graduation?
Walchand College of Engineering, Sangli.
Walchand, Sangli. Great. So here we have a student who used to travel from Sangli 250 kilometers from Pune. Oh, great. Can you just, it's truly inspiring. Can you just continue? So you used to come here for weekdays. Did you took a break in your engineering? How do you manage?
No. So I have always a simple motive that do not spend a lot of time or do not take a drop.
Okay.
So always go for how it goes in the flow. So I started the weekend batch and every weekend I used to come from Sangli to Pune.
Oh, great.
Yeah.
So you took a PG here, you stayed here for Saturday, Sunday,
yeah,
right? You used to travel from Sangli on Friday night, come here, again Sunday night.
And
oh,
Monday morning.
Yeah. So I think so then your college grades would have suffered a lot, right? Because 2 days you are spending here. So is it that case or your extracurricular activities?
Not actually. So I have a grade of 9.15. So that was never hampered.
9.15 CGPA, great.
So the college was pretty supportive about it.
Okay.
They said that the assignments were then, I was used to do it on time or
great.
Ask the teacher for, you can say, extension or something. The extracurricular part, I never compromised on that. In my final, I was the chief finance officer of my club.
Oh, great.
Along with that, I have managed events.
And Pranav, one specific incident, because I still remember while reviewing your form that you have traveled abroad also, right?
Yeah, Japan.
So can you tell our viewers more about it? Because some of the students would still be in their engineering, right? So it is definitely going to immensely help them to build their profile. And why you in so early with less than 10 months of experience cracked IIM Kozhikode, which is probably in the land of gods, right? Mm-hmm. Kerala.
So. Yeah. So the best time to prepare a profile is the college life. Mm-hmm. So I had learned this and my dad told me that too. So I thought that why not try everything? One of them was papers. So I had an international paper and due to which the conference I went to Japan.
Oh, and great. So international exposure, yeah. So early. In which year?
In my third year.
In your third year, great.
And even for my fourth year, that was the part why I didn't want to compromise academics, because my fourth year paper is going to be another conference.
Oh, great.
So I would urge everyone who is like watching this video that make your profile in these 4 years. Or if you have not, like if you're working right now, make every moment count. That is the best part.
Great, Pranav, a true inspiring story, right? Pranav, so you converted which calls this year?
IIM Kozhikode and IIFT.
And IIFT, great. Pranav, but with your so high percentile, right, you didn't apply to so many colleges because your calls were not as many as some other student, right? So why so less colleges?
Because I had always focused on the top 10. That great. I wouldn't go for anything else other than the top 10.
That was and age was on your side, right? You yes. started early, and that is why my friends, you need to learn a lot from students like Pranav, right? He started early, he got time, and he lived his dream. See, if you start early, the more time you get to live up to your dream and achieve it. Great, Pranav. Pranav, so you are a fresher. You were a fresher, right? When you were almost a fresher when you attended all these interviews, right?
Yeah.
So, can you throw some light on the GDPI part, right? How did you prepare for it? What were the kind of questions that were being asked? Because normally, when working students appear for an interview, the majority of the part or some part of the interview is definitely is reserved for the work experience part, right? But for you, it was not the case.
Yeah.
So how did you manage?
So the two main areas that I had were current affairs and the other one being academics. So current affairs, you need to study the paper, what is going on, the newspapers, what is trending in the market, all that stuff. And for academics, it's all about your college life. For me, I was a computer science student, so I had to have three main subjects.
Great.
And those subjects should be such that if they ask any question, you need to be able to answer everything about it.
So as a computer science graduate, which three subjects you focused on?
Mine was data structures,
algorithms
and database.
Perfect. So in most of the interviews, majority of the questions were either on academics or your...
You can never actually guess the trend. Some of the interviews were purely philosophical. Some were based on fully academics. Because in academics they ask which is your favorite subject, and they never ask that.
Perfect. And so they asked you your favorite subject, but they didn't ask any follow-up questions from that subject.
And it is always good if you don't know to say no.
Yes.
Because sometimes they might feel that you are trying to overshow.
Okay.
That was one of the part that I learned. And the other current affairs part, one of my IIM Calcutta interviews based on current affairs.
Great.
So you can never guess what is going on.
Okay. So current affairs has always been your strong part. As a student who is an engineering student, right? My dear friends, you need to understand that Pranav was an engineering student. He not only managed his academics, 9.15 CGPA, not only managed extracurricular activities, he was a chief financial officer, right? In the final year, he managed to travel to Japan for a conference, right? He managed all the extracurricular activities and yet he was good in current affairs, right? With current affairs, I still, can you tell our viewers, what was your score in GK in IIFT?
I scored 7 marks.
7 marks, great, right? So that helped you outside, right? So this is a true inspiring story where a student never wasted his time, right? Be it engineering, be it after engineering, be it work life, he always was focused to what he really wanted to do. Pranav, one more thing before I ask you our last question, which I have asked to all the students, right? But one last question before last question. Your DILR percentile, right? It is obviously one of the areas which I have seen most of the students struggle in DILR. So can you tell our viewers, how did you manage to score so high in DILR? Your actual score would be somewhere around?
54.
Right, great, right? So it means that you were able to ace more than 5-6 sets, right?
Yeah, 6 sets.
Great. So can you throw some light on your DILR preparation?
Okay, so the best part about DILR is you don't need to remember any formulas. In verbal, you need to remember how the author thinks, how it is going to say. In
various tones.
Yeah, the various tones. That was my very bad part actually. So in quant, you need to remember all the formulas, how it happens, what is the internal angle, external angle. DIL is the best part because no formulas. Just read the question, 50% is solved. You need to understand how DLR happens.
Great. So you used to solve a lot of puzzles, right?
Puzzles used to be one of my favorite thing during my childhood. And DLR is the one of the thing that you can solve even while you're doing some other work.
Great. Like, because you don't require a prior knowledge, right? So most of the students who are afraid of DILR, here there is a true advice from a person who has achieved 99.9%+ in DILR section in CAT, where this DILR section is supposed to be one of the toughest area in last 2-3 years, right? So Pranav, great. One last bit of question, right? A guru mantra which you would like to share with all, because I ask this to all our achievers, right? All of our viewers would definitely love to hear it from someone who's going to spend next 2 years in the land of God, which is IIM Kozhikode, right? So please,
One of the guru mantra that sir says would be respect time. If you respect time, time will respect you.
Yes.
I had a personal experience last year when I didn't fill the form of SPJN on time, and I could have converted it last year too. So it would have been, a year would have been saved, but maybe this year I was better. I'd made an Excel sheet, all the things were done on time. The institute would definitely help you, but it's you yourself who will think upon it.
Perfect. Great. So friends, see, here there is a person, right, who has been a true inspiring story for all the freshers across India. Respect your time, as he says, right? Never compromise on your academics in your graduation. Always give importance to your extracurricular activities, and you will still get time to do what you really want to do in future. Thank you very much, Pranav. It has been a great experience, right? Right? And this is a small token of appreciation from the entire Genesis family. We wish you all the very best for all your future endeavors. Right?
Thank you, sir.
You'll be in all our hearts, because we have seen very rare students who are in final year who do justice to all the things that they do, right? And our current affairs also, which is probably one of the weaker areas of all the engineers. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir.